League rule, which makes it a touchdown when a player merely breaks the imaginary plane of glass of the front of the goal line. Come on, give us a break. This is a bad rule. Number one, it cheapens the touchdown, and number two, it makes it almost impossible for the official to call. For example, let's go to the videotape of last Sunday's Giants-Eagles game. This is Wilbert Montgomery of the Eagles from the four-yard line. Now look at this. Is it a touchdown or not? The official rules it is because he believes Montgomery cracked the imaginary plane of the front of the goal line. To me, it's so close, I can't even see it on the replay. How's the official going to see it? I say change the rule once and for all. For a touchdown, the man must cross the entire goal line with the ball, not just the front plane of the goal line. Just a simple change. Number one, if the ball carrier would earn the touchdown, and number two, it'd make it easier for the official to call the play correctly. All right, let's go to the videotape, the plays of the week. Here we go. First of all, the best catch of the week had to be Mitchell Webster of the Toronto Blue Jays. Come on, Mitchell. All right. The catch of the week while falling down and doing a somersault, Leon Durham of the Cubs. The worst catch of the week, manager Pete Rose of the Reds, showing his players how not to do it. The worst balancing act by a first baseman jumping on the tarp, Don Mattingly of the Yankees. The brawl of the week, Yankees and the Angels. Ray Fontenot hits Juan Benitez. Fontenot throws his glove, and the rest of the Yankees and the Angels. The college catch of the week, Glenn Kozlowski of Brigham Young. The punch of the week, Pisa Fina facing you. Right hand coming into your living room. Boom. Down goes 6'5" Gary Lightbourne. The fight is over. The best move by a tennis player going into the stands. Jimmy Connors yesterday, U.S. Open. Have a drink, Jimmy. All right. This is Warner Wolf.